Here we have an example in Nozze di Figaro where the bourgeois, the noble, are losing the power, and Figaro and Susanna, which represent the low society, get the power against the bourgeoisie.
For many people, Nozze di Figaro is their favorite Mozart opera. Maestro Giulini, with who I worked, said always Figaro, for him, with Traviata and Carmen, maybe were the perfect opera for the story, for the drama, for the music. Mm-hmm. You know, it's one greatest hit after one greatest hit. So I think it reached the heart of the people even more maybe than any other Mozart opera. Of course it's a farce, it's a comedy, it's all people hiding from each other. And yet, underneath, in the orchestra, there's always this woodwind and there's always this violin line which breaks your heart. Every time with an orchestra, you have to agree on style, you have to agree on length, you have to agree on how you phrase, how you articulate, and then you start making music. With this orchestra, the vocabulary is in their blood, their flesh, their soul, their heart. And so it's immediately, directly to the music. Of course, now in our cycle, doing it the last of the three Da Ponte is very interesting instead of the first, because he writes a lot of piano, forte, crescendo in the vocal lines, because it was more new, not only to him, but to the singers, of course, and the musicians. What really excites me, inspires me as a conductor, is to have a mixture of legends in Mozart singing and new legends, I would say. So for me, all this communication, I think, inspires even without talking so much. And we have such a short time to put this together, and yet it becomes a miracle of inspiring everyone to give their best.
It's love, it's sex, and it's fun also, because all these things with the letter and the countess, who is so happy to come back in her, let's say, old times when she was a wild, savage girl, you know, from the village. And she's young, but in the same time, she has to act as somebody noble, but inside of her, she's coming from the people, you know, and I love it.
Every single role has a very definitive importance in the play. You know, it's very short, the role I'm playing in this one, Basilio, but you know, it's almost more stressful than any other that I have done and the ones that I will do, because in those specific moments you better have the right energy.
In quegli anni in cui val poco la malpratica ragion e bianch'io lo stesso foco. Fui quel pazzo cor non son, fui quel pazzo cor non son. E col tempo e coi perili, donna flemma capito. E i capricci e i puntigli, dalla testa di cavo.
It's also this complicity that you have managed, and you can see that there is this incredibly wonderful artistic connection between you and the orchestra, that you move, that you smile, that you sometimes are strict in things, and the whole thing comes to this place. It is just beautiful to see every single one of them with what energy, with what commitment.
Yes, commitment.
They play. I mean, we love this orchestra. I, of course, love this orchestra.
They listen at all times to the singers, to you. And it was fascinating so far to see the journey of wanting to do a real teamwork with the singers. To imprint my own vision of the piece, I feel even more lucky to be able to do this at this moment in my life with the best cast I can imagine at this moment.
It is a huge privilege, and it just is wonderful to be doing it with you, so I could not miss this one.